Each of the speakers will get about 5-7 minutes. You could either hold on to your questions, which is you could write them down and ask at the end of the session, so it will help us keep the time. Or if it's really a burning thing and you must take it right there, go ahead and just ask. But please keep it brief. So just to set the ball in motion, I thought I could talk for about 3-4 minutes before I call on the next speaker. So let's see. Education is actually very, very happening at this point in time. Not just because there's a lot of ICT coming in, but because I think that the tempo, the scenario, the business opportunities in education is so real time and something that offers a lot of revenue. It's an industry that is not, it's a recession-free industry. It actually does not follow the economic downturns of the countries. It does not get affected by the dollar slipping in comparison to the rupee. It's also something that's going to open up in terms of FDIs, right? There's been a huge talk going on. So given that, and given that corporates are looking at coming in, Educom has already set the trend, coming into content development, I think if any of you are in the room to look at economics for education, you're in the right place, seriously. What I'm going to do is, in the next couple of minutes, I'm going to just show you the experiences we've had through two of our schools right here in Ahmedabad, the DPS Bhopal and the DPS East. We decided to talk to students. At the end of the day, they are the beneficiaries of what is it that we are going to offer. And we asked them whether a machine is better than the teacher. And you'd be surprised that, I mean, if this was USA, I think it would be a resounding yes. But because it's still India, and because we still believe in human element, and we still respect Gurudeva and all of that, I think there's kind of a mixed response, where they're definitely saying that we learn through experience from our teachers, but our teachers are also too human. They complain to our parents. And every now and then we get a, you know, bashing in the class, which is like verbal bashing in the class. What's also happening is the freedom that digital learning offers at any place. They can sit and learn, I think, is the biggest thing that students would like to take home. So about 2 years ago, there's just an article that says that we completely did away with chalk and talk methods of teaching. And by that I mean physically. You can't do away with the visual mechanism, but we do no longer have green chalkboards. We started to have classrooms which are smart classes. I mean, it's actually no-brainer to tell you the advantages that you can have when you get into a completely digitized learning environment. Think of the entire data management, your entire transportation, your student management, your fee management, your continuous evaluations, your online modules, everything gets completely so streamlined. So what's going to happen is actually the teacher is more free for creativity, because the minimum standards of benchmarking, of standard of quality, you've actually ensured through digitization. So a lot of things happen, actually. The abstract, difficult curriculum actually becomes to come alive when you use a multimedia way of teaching. In India, digital online kind of teaching is really not yet there. In the US, in higher education, almost 50% of children actually do it online. They do not go to brick and mortar schools anymore. But in India, we have this slightly blended learning, which is a conventional and technology-aided learning. So I think one of the biggest aids this offers is it becomes less teaching and more learning inside the classroom. I'll run you through a really very, very brief kind of a experience as to how you can do, through a storytelling, you can actually teach real heavy stuff. So hi, I'm Mark. I'm 8 years old, and I'm a regular kid just like you. So I ride my bike, I sport, I you know, bike and swim and etc. But this is one thing you don't have that I have. You don't have a volcano in your backyard. So you've actually got the children's attention, and then you can go on actually to teach geography through Hawaii. Talk about all the islands, talk about how lava is formed, all of that. You can actually start to, through pictures, get into real deep discussions, like types of volcanoes, what is the composition, can you walk through a lava tunnel, all of that you can start to do. Which, if the teacher had to explain in the classroom, would be really very, very challenging. At the same time, there are huge challenges for the digital learning. I think children are so exposed today. I hate to say this, that our teachers are way behind in technology compared to the students. Way, way behind. And we call them the Facebook generation, right? And if education is about imparting information, then teachers have no role to play at all. Because one search on one Google bar, they can get so much information that students can't handle anymore. So education has to really get revamped into value addition, into character building, into facilitation, not so much information. But there are a lot of challenges. Identity theft, security, children really don't know what they're posting. Sometimes they know a lot more than they should know. Can you imagine 12-year-olds visiting porn sites because it's so completely available? So a lot of things happen ahead of the time, which is actually quite risky. So I already mentioned the Facebook generation. These are some stats for them. They typically spend about 5-6 hours a day on social media. This is the current generation that we are talking about. These are not children who read anymore. I mean, if parents are going to say that develop a reading habit and they should read 2 hours a day, forget it. Children no longer read 2 hours a day. If they put even 2 hours a whole month, you should thank your stars. These are kids that spend hours on TV, hours on social media. They learn more from Google and technology than, like I said, face-to-face classrooms. So times have really changed. And I'm hoping some of the panelists will bring up other elements of the classrooms, because everybody here is a practitioner. They belong to real-time issues, classrooms, principals, management, administration, those kind of issues. And I'm sure you're going to get a lot more. But I'm going to wrap this up saying that unless teachers begin to understand that times have changed, and in order to capture the interest of students, they have to stay ahead, I think we as a teaching fraternity will become archive and like dinosaurs. Thank you so much.